Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. So for today's video, tayo ay magsasubtract ng mixed numbers and simple fractions. Pero kung mapansin natin, sa ating gawing subtraction ngayon, mag-borrow tayo sa ating mga whole numbers. So ito yung mga list, mga street skill ng mga bata, ang pagsasubtract, lalo na kapag meron ng borrow. Lalo na kapag fraction na ang ating sinusolve. So, let's now try to answer our examples. First example, we have 5 and 1 third minus 2 thirds. So, as you can see, hindi natin pwedeng i-minus ang ating subtrahend dahil 2 is greater than 1. So, magbigay ito ng hindi ito sagot sa atin. So, kailangan natin mag-borrow ng 5 at magdayo ng bagong action doon sa 1 ngayon na i-add din kay 1 third. Pag 1 third ay mag greater than 2 thirds. Meron tayong video ng whole number na sasubtract sa simple fractions. So, pwedeng sundan yun. So, balikan lang natin. Short recap. So, paano natin gagawin ngayon yung ating pagsasubtract? Dahil 2 is greater than 1, kailangan natin mag-borrow kay 5. So, ano yung gagawin natin? Look at our denominator here. This So, yung 1 na ibabawas natin kay 5, ay bubuin natin ng isang bagong fraction. So, ito nga yun yun. So, si 5, pag binawasan ng isa, magiging 5 lang. At yung 1 whole na tinanggal natin sa kanya, ay naging 3 over 3, or 3 thirds. Saan natin nakuha si 3 thirds? Tinignan natin yung denominator ng ating fraction dito. So, dahil ito ay 3, so, ginamit natin si 3 thirds. Pwede tayo, again, ha, gumamit ng ibang numbers. Pwede 5, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, kahit anong number, as long as pareho sa numerator and denominator. Pero dahil nga tayo ay mag-a-add sa ating number, alam naman natin rules, addition of fractions, kailangan they are always similar. So, kung gagamit tayo ng ibang numbers, kailangan pa natin kunin yung LCD nila. Okay? So, matatagalan tayo habang process. So, para hindi na tayo mahirapan, ang gagamitin na natin dito ay yung ating denominator. So, dahil ay 3, ang ating 1 na binaro kay 5 ay magiging 3 over 3 or 3 thirds. This is also equivalent to 1. So, 1 plus 4, 5 pa rin. Okay, so 4 and 3 thirds, we will now add sa ating 1 third. Kailangan kasi maging greater yung value ni 1 third kay 2 thirds. Kaya tayo ay nag-borrow ng 1 kay 5. So 4 and 3 thirds plus 1 third, that is equivalent to 4 and 4 thirds. As you can notice sa ating mixed number dito, our numerator now is greater than our denominator. Obviously, this is greater than 1. Kasi nga, nag-borrow tayo ng 1 kay 5. So, pag ito ay ginawa ulit natin na fraction or number, sinilipay pa natin ginating proper ating fraction dito, babalik lang yan sa 5 and 1 thirds. 1 third. So, let us now proceed to our subtraction. So, we have 4 and 4 thirds minus, copyin natin si thirds. Okay? So, huwag kakalimutan kung paano nakuha si 4 thirds sa dito yan, si 5 and 1 third. Ayan. Kaya nagkaroon tayo ng 4 and 4 thirds. Then proceed to subtraction. So we will now proceed to 4. Since wala naman mga minus kay whole number na 4, ikakopy lang natin siya. Then we will now subtract our numerators. 4 minus 2. Then since pareho ang ating denominator, we will just copy 3. So 4 minus 2, that is equivalent to 2 thirds. So 4 and 2 thirds. So, our final answer here is 4 and 2 thirds. Next example, we have 3 and 2 fifths minus 4 fifths. So, as you can notice again, the numerator of our subtrahend is greater than the numerator of our minuend. So, hindi natin ito pwede minus. So, anong gagawin natin? Kailangan ulit itong maging greater than 4. So, magbabaro tayo ng 1 kay 3. So, si 3, pag binawasan ng isa, magiging 2 na lang. So, natin dadalhin yung 1 na binaro natin kay 3 sa ating denominator ito. Magbubuo tayo ng bagong fraction. So, si 3 magiging 2 and 5 fifths. That is equivalent to 1 whole. So, 1 plus 2, 3 pa rin. Okay, so si 3 naging 2 and 5 fifths plus yung ating fraction na 5. Okay, so 5 plus 2, that is equivalent to 7. Copy the denominators na 5. Then 2 plus, wala naman tayong whole number, so we will just copy 2. So 3 and 2 fifths, that is equivalent to 2 and 7 fifths. So kapag ito ay sinimplify pa natin, babalik lang yan sa 3 and 2 fifths. Okay? So next, we will now proceed to subtraction. 2 and 7 fifths minus, ito natin subtrahend ng 4 fifths. So, wala tayong minus kay 2 na whole number, so we just copy 2. 7 minus 4 all over 5 dahil they are similar fractions. We'll just copy the denominator. So 7 minus 4, that gives us 3. Copy the denominator 5 and the whole number 2. So our final answer here is 2 and 3 fifths. Okay, so sana may natutunan tayo. Now it's your turn. Try to answer our 3 examples. So you can pause this video kung kayo ay nagsasagot na. Medyo tinanggal natin yung timer kasi mahaba yung kinoconsume na minutes ng ating timer. So you can pause this video para magsagot. So kung kayo ay tapos na magsagot, let us now show our answers. Try to check your own paper and be honest with the result. So, for number 1, 5 and 1 fifth minus 3 fifths, this gives us the answer 4 and 3 fifths. Next, 7 and 3 eighths minus 4 eighths, it gives us 6 and 7 eighths. And last, 12 and 4 tenths minus 5 tenths, that is 11 and 9 tenths. So, I hope meron tayong natutunan para sa ating video na ito. And nawa na perfect ninyo yung ating tatlong examples, practice exercises. So, thank you for watching our video. Stay safe everyone and God bless you all.